In this module, we'll talk about the kinetics of radioactive decay. So, radioactive isotopes, when they decay, obey a first order rate law, just like we saw back when we first started talking about kinetics. And so, it ends up that the natural log of the number of nucleides present at whatever time you're talking about, time t, over the initial number of nucleides present at t equals zero is equal to negative k times t. T is the time, and k is the rate constant. So first order kinetics, we can use this equation. Nice, simple one. The half-life, okay, for a nuclide is just the time that it takes for half of the initial nuclides to decay. In other words, n at time t 1/2 is equal to 1/2 of the original number of nuclides. So, plugging into the first order rate law, natural log of 1/2 of n0 over n0, n0's cancel, equals negative k, and that t, that's what we mean by t 1/2. Rearrange this just a little bit, and we get t 1/2 equals natural log of 2 over k. So you should memorize this, because we use it for radioactive decay. So, what is half-life? Half-life's time that it takes for half of the original amount present to decay. Because it's a first order rate law, the time 1/2 doesn't change. It stays constant as time goes on. So let's say we start with 10 grams of strontium-90 right here. And its half-life, it ends up, is 28.9 years. So after 28.9 years, we'll have half of that, or 5 grams, present. After one more half-life, which is another 28.9 years, we'll have half of the 5, which is 2.5 grams, and then so on, keeps on going. The T 1/2 stays the same. In each, we could have started here with 2.5 grams as our T zero, and after one half-life, we'd have half of that, which is 1.25, after 28.9 years. So let's say we have a sample of plutonium-239, which is used in what are called breeder reactors. And this has a half-life of 24,100 years. Let's figure out how long would it take for a sample of plutonium-239 to decay to 0.1% of its original value. So this is a two-step calculation. First, we're going to use the half-life that we're given to find the rate constant. Once we know the rate constant, we can solve for the time that it takes to do this. So, using this equation here, rearranging, solving for k, the rate constant, natural log of 2 over the half-life, plugging in, we get about 2.88 times 10 to the minus 5th per year as the rate constant k. Now, for the time that it takes for a sample to decay to 0.1%, 0.1% is 0.001 of the original amount. So 0.00100 times n0 over n0, n0's cancel. Natural log of that equals negative k, this is now that we know k, times the time. Solve for t, right? Just rearrange a little bit. T equals natural log of 0.001 over this, and we get about, 240,000 years, 2.40 times 10 to the fifth years. That's a long time.